nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky.
A sweep, how sweet it tastes, sweet for the revenge of yesteryear. A sweep can mean but nothing if the success be short-lived. Supervened only by Stanley shall a sweep be sempiternally sweet.
Oh, get rid of that then.
So, game four last night. Much closer game than the previous three games. Obviously finished 3-1. You know, it wasn't as open as 3-1 suggests, not really suggests, but, you know, it wasn't really worthy of a two-goal cushion. You know, good fortune, really, was the story of that game. Right before Penguins' first goal, the centre, Mr. Short, had an opportunity, really close one, just missed the post and pretty much went straight up the other end and put it away for the one-goal lead. Also, there's the disallowed goal, which I'll come to later. The Sens' first goal was the first real mistake I'd seen from the Penguins this series. It was one of my favourite players, Max Talbot, on the boards down at the blue line. He found a bit of traffic, and instead of dumping it in, he tried to feed a pass inside for Adam Hall, I think it was, but it was a turnover, and they went straight up the other end, and a little bit of pressure in our zone, and then they scored. So it was a shame, but, you know, we bounced back and we got the win. That was the main thing, but that's something you probably need to look at. Just dump it in, get the change, because they were probably looking for a change, but he looked up, saw Hall coming and tried to feed it in, and it didn't work. Back to the disallowed goal. It looked pretty genuine when at full speed when we saw it, and even on the first couple of replays it looked okay, but then it emerged that in fact it was kicked in. You know, I think it was Gary Galley on the CBC commentary. He was just adamant that it should be a goal because he hadn't intended to kick it in. Yes, that's right, he didn't intend to kick it in, he tends to kick it to his stick, but his stick was checked. And the fact is, it was a kick, it did go in, straight in, it's no goal. And as Jim Houston rightly stated, you can't judge someone's intent from a video. If it was no goal, that's the way it is, that's the rules. Regardless of what he intended to do, no goal, good call. You know, as I would say, but anyway. Fleury didn't really have any big saves to make in the game. You know, he was solid throughout, but, you know, not spectacular. One save really of note was the one off Commodore. He just stepped into the slot, no one there to pick him up, and he fired it straight at Fleury, and he sat on it. About 5 minutes after that, once again the third and fourth liners got it done. Kennedy and Rutu got a takeaway at our blue line. Kennedy fed a nice little pass into Rutu, and, you know, I'm getting more confident in Rutu's ability to score. He's becoming quite a threat, you know, strange enough. It took him two attempts, but he got it in, and it was fantastic. Third period was just so intense, you know. You could tell that if Ottawa had got that tying goal, then they would have probably gone on to win it in OT. But they didn't get it, and Crosby sealed it with the empty netter, and there we have a sweep. Fantastic result. And, you know, we've got about a week off and just rest up and work on, you know, scout the team that we're going to play. And then get to it. But the next round is going to be a real test. Whoever we play is going to be much more difficult, much more physical. The team we play is going to have more offense, better defense, probably better goaltending. And, you know, it's going to be a tough one. Possible opponents are the Bruins, the Caps, the Rangers, or the Devils. Let's just go through them one by one. The Bruins are losing, looking like they're going to lose their series to the Canadiens, but you never know. I don't really want to play them. If you look at their last two games in the regular season against them, they've pretty much just nullified our offense. They've got a good trap going on. They beat us 2-1 and then 5-1 in the last two games. And, you know, we thrive on offense and goals. And if we can't get it, then they've probably got a good chance. The Caps would be my preference. I'm confident we can beat them if we play them. You know, Ovechkin has yet to fire for them. But, you know, if they do get through against the Flyers, then I guess it'll be him that does it. But, you know, either way, it'd be fantastic to see Penguins and Caps game. Of the Devils and Rangers, it's difficult. I don't really know who I'd want to play more. Either one could hurt us. Either one could curl up and we could run over them. you know, if we do play the Rangers, it'll probably be quite fun with Avery there, and hopefully Gary Roberts will be back in the lineup and fit again, and could have a good series there if we play them. Now, just one more point. I was watching the CBC feed, and Don Cherry in one of the breaks, you know, I've got a lot of respect for him. I like his ideas, and I especially like what he was saying about Mark Savard and his stick, and I love the way that he kind of talks to the kids watching at home, trying to, you know, nurture them into good hockey players. But he said that Carey Price must win the Calder Trophy, which, you know, it's just, it's probably nothing to think of, you know, it's just Don Cherry being Don Cherry, but, you know, he's done well and he deserves to be on that shortlist. But his argument being that he's 20 and he's, you know, held the Habs up is, yeah, he's done well, but it's 40 games he's played, okay, you know, a lot of goaltenders only play 60, but it's 40 games, and yeah, he's done well, but I think he's riding the belief in him at the moment. And someone like Patrick Kane, he's 18, he's put up 78 points, I think, this season, and he doesn't have a great team around him. Okay, he's got John Taves and he's got Robert Lang, and but it's, you know, he's done so well this year, and I think he's going to get it. You know, I'd hazard a guess, if Kane was Canadian, Don Cherry wouldn't have said what he said, so there we go. Anyway, I think that's about it.